Should we maybe re-enlist him? What do you think? Well, thank you for that warm welcome, and a special thanks to Chief Pete Anders for your support and friendship over the many years. Thank you, Dr. McElwain, Mr. Warfel, for that kind introduction. President Anderson, Millersville University, thank you for this distinct honor. I'm extremely grateful and truly humbled. I'd also like to take this opportunity to recognize and to thank my wife, Robin, my parents, Harry and Pat Mann, my mother-in-law, Jacqueline Priester, my brother-in-law, Paul Priester, here with us today for their love and support. Good morning, parents, families, and friends, and a special good morning to the class of 2014. Give yourself a round of applause. You know, right now I realize that I'm the only thing standing between you and the rest of your lives, so I'll endeavor to keep this brief and to the point. In fact, it reminds me of a story about the importance of brevity. Schoolboy was given an assignment to write a report about a famous person. He chose Julius Caesar. His essay went something like this. Julius Caesar was born a long time ago. He was a great general. He won important battles. He gave a long speech. They killed him. So I'll try to keep my remarks short and to the point so I avoid a similar fate. Today I'd just like to share a couple of perspectives with you. First, recognizing one's accomplishments. Secondly, the importance of perseverance. And third, never missing an opportunity to be appreciative and to say thank you. Turning first to accomplishments, we all know that pride is one of our most powerful human endeavors. The feeling you get when you recognize all that you have accomplished. It also provides you with the confidence to tackle future goals, both personal and professional. In fact, you've already accomplished a lot. Currently, only one in three Americans 25 years of age and older has earned a bachelor's degree. And over the course of one's career, those with college degrees earn approximately $1 million more than those who do not. So I guess you're all future millionaires. And maybe you can pick up the check for dinner tonight instead of your parents. You know, the journalist Tom Brokaw wrote the book, The Greatest Generation, detailing the exploits of men and women who fought in World War II and who built modern America that we know today. And while this generation accomplished numerous incredible feats by any standard, many Americans feel that our best days are behind us. I personally don't believe that story has been written yet. You know, baby boomers have been called greedy, selfish, and narcissistic. Generation Xers have been called cynical and apathetic. Your generation, Generation Y, millennials, is described as having all these attributes, but with a limited attention span due to social media, texting, and tweeting. I'm going to let you in on a secret. According to the Corporation of National and Community Service, since 2012, approximately 14 million millennials volunteer every year, constituting over 1.4 billion hours of service. I believe it's fair to say that all generations have been characterized in one way or another. It will be up to you how history will describe your generation and what the world will be like for your children and for your grandchildren for many years to come. You know, since its inception, our nation has faced many challenges, both at home and abroad. And like previous generations, you will also face unique issues that have not been encountered or even imagined. Your world will be different, complex and challenging in many ways. So take pride in your accomplishments today and, more importantly, what you will accomplish in the future, much of which will be based upon your degree of perseverance. You know, I like to tell the story about a good friend of mine who wanted to be a doctor. His father was a doctor. His grandfather was a doctor. And he was determined to achieve this goal. So after graduating from college, he promptly applied to all the medical colleges that he could. But he was rejected by every single one of them. So what he did was he retook the medical college admission test. He retook courses to raise his grade point average. And after all this hard work, he reapplied to medical school the next year and was again rejected by every school. So you can imagine his frustration and his disappointment. He could have given up, and no one would have blamed him. Instead, he drove on, and on his third attempt, he was accepted into a medical school in Philadelphia. Today, he is a very successful doctor. You know, I asked him once what kept him going on, and he said that each time that he was rejected, he had to reevaluate his commitment to his goal, whether to carry on or to quit. You know, I believe that he felt that eventually he would become such a desirable candidate that medical schools would have to accept him, or they would just get tired of his constant calls and letters and would just bring him in anyway. You know, Winston Churchill would summarize his situation something like this: success is the ability to go from one failure to another without any loss in enthusiasm. In life, success is not predetermined. I believe we all have the requisite number of brain cells. But what separates the most successful from everybody else? I believe it comes down to perseverance, never giving up. You know, life can be challenging and everyone experiences failures along the way. As the old poem goes, it's not what happens to the person, but what happens in the person. In times of setback, we must pause, learn, and continue on. This is perseverance. It's the pure grit that allows those determined few to rise above the chaos of life's many challenges. You know, Oscar Wilde was fond of saying that quotation is the best substitute for wit. So I'd like to paraphrase a quote from President Theodore Roosevelt. No doubt some of you have heard this, so please bear with me. It is not the critic that counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust, sweat, and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes up short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who strives to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasm, great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at best knows the triumph of high achievement, and who, if he fails, at least he fails daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold, timid souls who neither know victory nor defeat. So embrace adversity and persevere, because it's in times of challenge we learn the strength of the human spirit and grow as individuals. Finally, I'd like to stress the importance of never missing an opportunity to say thank you and to appreciate your many blessings. You know, I appreciate this university. In my opinion, and I might be a little biased here, there are few institutions of learning that rival Millersville. And in fact, according to a U.S. News and World Report on Best Colleges for 2014, Millersville ranked 22 in the category of top public schools for all regional universities in the North. In terms of a return on investment, Millersville graduates enjoy one of the largest pay gaps when compared with those without a degree, and on average, earn more than graduates of other Pennsylvania schools. Bottom line, students and parents, Millersville is a very wise investment. I personally attribute any success that I've achieved over my life to my wife, Robin, and to the valuable lessons that I've learned here. There's a good reason why this school has received such impressive rankings. I feel the size of the university creates a powerful connection between the professor and the student, difficult to replicate at larger schools. A student-to-faculty ratio of 22 to 1 is very hard to beat. There's also a special bond between the members of a small class, the late-night cramming sessions, the friendships that help make today possible. With just over 1,000 students graduating, you have developed a unique connection that will last a lifetime. So please stay in touch. Continue to provide each other with support and encouragement. It's also very important for you to take pride in your country. I've spent a long and personally rewarding career in the military. I've had the privilege to serve alongside some of the most selfless and dedicated young Americans that this country has ever produced. I've had the opportunity to travel throughout the world and to live in some unique and, in some cases, challenging environments. You know, it's interesting how much you miss your home and appreciate it when you're away. You know, there are many amazing countries throughout this world, which I'm sure students from other countries can attest to. But I'm here to tell you to be proud of your country and to be grateful for the liberties that we enjoy. There are many children in many places throughout the world who have a better shot at life due to the sacrifices, in some cases, the ultimate sacrifices of many young Americans. Frankly, our position on the world stage comes with responsibilities to maintain our way of life and distinction as one of history's great cultures. I challenge you to stay engaged, work within your communities, continue to volunteer, vote. Don't let your country be shaped without your involvement. And while I'm on the subject of staying engaged, I'd like to recognize some individuals who decided to begin their careers with service to our nation. The following members of Class 2014 were commissioned as second lieutenants in the United States Army earlier today. Second Lieutenant Timothy Bolton. Second Lieutenant Jason Hendricks. Second Lieutenant Benjamin Rento. Congratulations to each of you. Well done, please. In conclusion, don't forget your professors and faculty here at Millersville. Stay in touch with them. Frankly, you're part of their family. They made a tremendous investment in your development and in your preparation. They like to know how you're doing. Turning to your families, your mothers and fathers and sisters and brothers, those that are responsible for who you are and what you will become, and who will always love you and worry about you no matter how old you get, let's give them a round of applause. And don't forget to call them every now and again. Believe me, it's much appreciated. And also, by the way, a hug and a kiss goes a long way, so do that too. So be proud of what you've accomplished. Never give up on your dreams. Always remember to appreciate your many blessings. I wish you the very, very best of luck, prosperity, and a fulfilling life. Thank you. God bless. Now let's pass out some diplomas.